So I thought I would just bring in some pipe. I'm not going to bring any manufacturers into it, but you'll probably guess where it's from, okay? So if you're doing long runs, great. Straight bit of conduit, buy this. It's cheap, it does a purpose. But if you've got lots of bends, sets, it's no good. It'll just do that to your, it'll just do that to your conduit bender, yeah? So I'll just give you a little demonstration. I don't know if any of you have ever done plastic conduit, but you have the piece of cable on there so you can, you know how long this spring is. Say you need to bend a 90 degree here. So you would put your bending spring on there and then you would bend up to your cable like so. And you know exactly how deep that is going to go, yeah?
And you're going for knee, not Superman.
Knee?
Yeah, you're going over knee?
Yeah.
Okay.
So this is the not so good conduit, okay? So normally you'd mark that with a pencil. I know exactly where it is. So you'd warm it up, okay? And then you go on your knee. Cool. And straight away, yeah? You can see exactly what's happened to that conduit, yeah? And then when you go back, it's completely jammed, yeah? And then it will bend your spring. That's where I've just bent that, so it started to break the spring again. So that is now scrap. You can't use that, okay? So I'll use my new spring. So this is just probably twice the price conduit, yeah? But if you're doing bends, it's gonna save you the money. Let's hope it works now, eh? So warm it up and then go over your knee. And then you can just bend it. Okay, see the difference? Conduit is keeping its shape, yeah? And it springs back to a 90 degree for you. There you go.